Monster, how you doing? Thought of you. Oh, it's that great time of the year when the gardens come to the kitchen and you've got peppers, you've got tomatoes, you've got just about everything you could imagine. And we've been using those on the last few shows. What we're going to do today is something. We're going to cook down some tomatoes when we make our sauce. Now, first of all, let me tell you, there is no better smell in the world than tomatoes cooking on a stove. And when you get enough of these in a pot and you cook it down, oh, the sauce is so great. Now, hush pet, 1 second. I didn't have a whole, you know, and some people, they got 2 or 3, 4 or 5 bushel baskets. I only had a little bit, so I used some paste with mine. But the seeds and the pieces of the fresh tomato are there. And then I just got it, cooked it down, added the paste, and put it on top of my macaroni. Because, oh, and we had linguine. It was just perfect with meatballs and sausage. And I know we did that in another show, you know, making sauce, but we didn't do fresh tomatoes. Now in the middle, I got some peppers from the garden and I cored them so that someday we'll have stuffed peppers. And you'll be able to go back to this and see how I put them in the freezer. Now, without any further ado, and Abe, you're riding your camel too. Johnny's still going, I don't like peppers, but Copple likes everything, so him and Marianne are good. It's another exciting, thrilling edition of Cooking a Castle coming your way. Don't go away, we'll be right back.
450 Newcastle's community television station. This program was provided through funding from Cedars Restaurant in Newcastle, Pennsylvania. A special thanks to Cedars, featuring Middle Eastern, Italian, and American cuisine.
Yes, tomatoes. And how great at this time of the year. The first thing we're gonna do is wash these tomatoes, put them in hot water, and get the skin off. Then we're gonna cook them down, and it'll be great. We'll have some tomato sauce and some pasta. Now, after letting these soak in hot water, the skin will come off real easy. Some people use a paring knife, but we'll peel them and put them into our pot so that we can begin to cook them down. There. Our tomatoes all nice and peeled. Get them under there so you can see a little bit better. Now we're gonna cook this down on low to medium heat. The smell is gonna be unbelievable. And just watch this.
Peppers, mouth-watering fruit, fine dressings, apples, meats. This place looks so familiar. Everyone in Newcastle has to know about it. Yes, it reminds you of when you were growing up. Right in downtown Newcastle. Look at those fine lunch meats and ethnic foods. Yes, it's Joseph's.
Simple elegance in a majestic setting. Yes, right here in downtown Newcastle. Minutes away from shopping. Seconds from a gas station. And let's not forget pastries, a restaurant,
And oh yes, the schools. The Majestic, for that majestic lifestyle, right in the greatest castle, Newcastle. Come by and take a look.
Now this is a simple little deal. Yeah, I know we're making our sauce, but these gardens full of all this great produce. I'm gonna core these peppers, of course, after washing them. So as I was saying, we're gonna wash these up and core them and put them in a freezer bag and just put them in the freezer. Gardens plentiful at this time, and these will make great stuffed peppers. When it gets a little colder out, and it'll be something to taste. And there you go. Freezer ready, cored, cleaned. Great for one of those winter days when stuffed hot peppers sound so good.
Great dining experience. Today's programming is brought to you by NCTV 45 and NC Radio 450, Newcastle's community television station.
Now look at that sauce. Y'all, if you had smell-o-vision, it is unreal. There's nothing like the smell of tomatoes that are cooking down. And now we're gonna let it simmer. We're gonna add some meatballs, and we're cooking our meatballs separately, and then we'll put those in there and we'll put it over our pasta. Now we made some meatballs, and they go into our sauce. And we're cooking up some sausage. We'll put that in there. And then we'll serve this with linguine. Now, we did some linguine. We're going to put this in the colander and then dress it with our sauce. And some macaroni and meatball. So what a great thing. But homemade sauce. Wow. Now, here's our sauce, all nice and thick, and you could see the little pieces of tomato in there. We use some paste to thicken it up, and now we'll serve it with our linguine. Now there you go, our fresh homemade tomato sauce, straight from the garden of tomatoes.
Special thanks to Little Johnny's 2 Downtown, who provided funding for this program.
At our law firm, we see you. Come see us at lgkg.com.
Now, wasn't that excellent? Oh, if you had smell-o-vision and you could smell those tomatoes, they were... Oh, the aroma. Oh, there aren't words in Italian or English to describe it. It is just the most beautiful smell you'll ever see. Smell, see, ah. And that sauce, it just adhered to that pasta. It was just absolutely perfect. So try it. You know, if you have 3-4 dozen tomatoes, put them in hot water just like we did, and peel them and start cooking them down, and then use it for your macaroni some Sunday, or anytime. And they're gonna go, oh, where did she learn this? She must have really went to some big fancy school. But you and I both know, you watched Cooking a Castle right here on NCTV 45. And it's like I said, they're gonna love it. Till next time, bon appetit. A star that I know of, where lovers enjoy peace of mind. Let us leave.